ASMR world hope we're all good. It is Wednesday. That can only mean one thing here on the channel, that it is Thursday tomorrow and it was Tuesday yesterday. No, it's Wednesday. Yeah. Karate Wednesday. No, it's Conspiracy Wednesday. We're not doing karate lessons today. Hell no. We'll do some Brazilian jiu-jitsu another day. Today it's Conspiracy Wednesday and Haircut Wednesday for Ollie. Getting a haircut today, hopefully, if the missus agrees. So, a couple of days ago, I was given a reminder of why I will never buy a robot when they become fashionable. Technology is not the way forward. You think you can rely on your phone to record what you're recording? You can't. Either the phone or the microphone did a number on me. And I recorded this video 2 days ago. And I checked it out yesterday to upload it today. And the video wasn't working. I was talking, so I was like that. I was laughing, I was doing loads of entertaining shit. And there was no sound. So we're reverting to time. I'm going to have to stop this video every 5 minutes to make sure it's recording. Today, Ollie brings you the truth, as only Ollie can. That's me. I'm talking in the third person, in all honesty. It's a bit irritating, isn't it? You come here on a Wednesday every couple of weeks. Well, you used to. You will be again. For the truth. The whole truth. And nothing but the truth. You want the truth. You can't handle the truth. Yeah. John Nicholson. A few good men. I'm going to give you today the truth, okay? Today's subject is the royal family. Now, we all know the royal family has been a dodgy bunch of buggers. Literally, the most privileged, snivelly little shits you could wish to meet. And they've managed to do it with a few backhanders. I'm going to get into it all in a moment. But they have a sex pest for a son. We all know that's the truth. They have connections to the Nazi party. Or Germans, rather. They might have been Nazis for all I know. They, realistically, should not be in those big castles. You know, what's wrong with them living on a council estate in Sheffield and turning Buckingham Palace into a theme park or a homeless shelter? I'd back that any day of the week. But one thing we need to get to the bottom of is, were they in on it? You know what I'm on about here. We're going to get to the bottom of that right now, guys. Now, to say I make enemies everywhere I go would not be an understatement. Today I'm going to piss off the royal family. In the past I've pissed off the Nazis. I've had in for Donald Trump in the past. I've probably had Al-Qaeda on the go on this channel. We just go all out. So I need to put the warning out there now, so all you 200 people who watch this video can back me up on this. If I fall off a mountain, yeah, if I somehow walk under a bus, or I spray some aftershave on myself and miraculously disappear, you need to have my back. Yeah, I've pissed off the wrong people. So just in case that does happen, be warned, they could come for you next. I'm just getting out there. I'm just covering my own back. That I did not walk under a bus. I did not go mountain climbing and fall off the edge, because there's nobody mountains in Wolverhampton. And I did not spray some dodgy aftershave, unless it was the one I got from Next for Christmas. Then that was my mum's fault. Right, let's get into this, guys. Lovely jubbly water, all part of my healthy living that I started a day ago. I've done alright, you know. I'm on plan. I've only had 3 biscuits yesterday, as opposed to the 10 I'd normally have. So we're cutting out the sugar and the rubbish. We're replacing it with water and exercise. Yeah. Right. The royal family. The dramatic, ever-changing story of the royal family is perhaps the longest-running and most enjoyed soap opera the world has ever known. Don't lie. is a forehead. And rather than a tooth, they got a tuff. So weird. Hang on, Milo, wake up. The dog man flipping egg. He's in on the conspiracy. Milo, wake up. Yeah, he's not having any of it. I think he's a secret spy for the royals. They are the royal family, and their lives take precedence over the perceived mundanity in the lives of their fans. My life is a mundane, and I'm not a fan. In its current incarnation, the British royal family stems from the House of Windsor, a family tree that can trace its roots to Germany. Under the stern eye of Queen Elizabeth II, the royal family has endured much in its past few years, but the death of Diana, we're going to get into Diana in a minute, Princess of Wales in 1997, put the spotlight on the family with a white hot glare not seen before. Let's backtrack here a little bit, guys, to when I was 12 years old, right? There I was, 12 years old, I'm sure it was a Saturday. Must have been because I was off school. I'm sure it was. My mum wakes me up. Wake up, wake up. Said my real name. She didn't say Ollie because that's not my real name. But I'm not saying my real name. Only one person on here, apart from my missus, knows my real name. And that person will be kept anonymous. Alright, Kev. Anyways. So, what happened? Yeah, my mum wake me up. Wake up, you little sod. Get out of bed. Alright, what's going on, mum? What's happening? What's happened? Sorry, broke in. Has the TV broken? No. Princess Di has died. What? I'm 12 years old. Who the heck is Princess Di? Literally, I did not know much about the royals at 12. I was all about the football and the chocolate. Princess Diana has died. She's died in a car crash. Oh. Alright, I'm going to sleep now. That was not meant as disrespectful to Diana. I just did not know anything about the royal family. If I'd known she was the better part of the whole family, I would have called a crisis meeting. I'd have wrote letters of dissent to the royal family. I'd have started my conspiracy theories at 12 years old. But I did not know enough about her or about her ex-husband and the big... Okay, I've had to edit a little bit out there. I'm not going to tell you why. Because he just wasn't entertaining. But he's gone. So let's forget all about it, eh? It'll be found on the cutting room floor of my editorial suite. In it, a world mourning the loss of Diana, its most beloved princess, watched to see how the family would react. Well, I don't think Charles did too bad, did he? He had a new missus within a few years. Oh, mummy, can I please get back with Camilla? Charlie, do you have to? I cannot stand that wench. Oh, but mummy, I really need somebody. I have to have a missus on my arm. Yes, but that wench, she does not shut up jibber-jabbering all the way through Coronation Street. The last time she was here, I missed who Ken had had an affair with. But mummy, I will keep her out of the way. My ears are big enough for the two of us to clean every day. I'll keep her just swinging away like that on my ears, mummy. Okay, Charlie, but bring me a McDonald's on your way home from the brothel. Okay, mummy, no problem. That's how the conversation went. Guaranteed, I was there. Where are we up to? Oh, here we go. But even as the memorial flowers had been mounted against the security fences surrounding royal homes. I have one home. I don't have homes. Why do they get homes? I'm sorry, guys. I keep losing where I'm up to here. We're finally swept away. The story continued to unfold. Images of Diana and other members of the royal family are sold on everything from books and videos to commemorative tea towels. I love wiping my dishes clean with the Queen's face. But behind the smiles and waving hands, behind the castle gates and power of British tradition, just what is the royal family truly up to? What dark secrets lay hidden in their palatial closets? Are they really spaces an episode, even when she has to go and give her speeches on Christmas Day. Paul Burrell, yes, can you make sure you record Coronation Street, please? Yes, and Strictly Come Dancing, I'm thinking of taking part next year. Oh yes, I am. The strange part, well, apart from the fact that it's not the camera, when the Queen dramatically stopped the trial of Paul Burrell, as we just mentioned, Princess Diana's butler, who was charged with theft of her possessions, she created a scandal that more than rivaled any toe-sucking or lurid found sex headlines caused by more junior members of her family. Now, I don't know who did the toe-sucking, but I reckon them corgis of hers had a good old lick on someone's toes at one point. After it emerged that she had conveniently forgotten to tell police that Burrell was innocent until a few minutes before he was to take the stand, it also came to light that after Diana's death, the Queen had told Burrell to beware of dark forces operating in the country. You know how it went. Right, Paul. Yes, Queenie. I know you're innocent. Yes, I am, Queenie. I did not do anything. I did not take those licorice all sorts out of Diana's bedroom. I know, Paul. It was me. When she wasn't looking, I ate all the licorice all sorts. Then, why am I about to stand trial for it then, Queenie? Because, Paul, there are dark forces at work in the country. Yeah, how does that affect me? I am behind the dark forces. Like, Darth Vader, Queenie. No, not like Darth bloody Vader, Paul. Like, I am the Queen. Everyone bows down to me, including Tony. Who? Tony Christie, the one who walked 500 miles or whatever. Or Amarillo. No, not bloody Tony Christie, Paul. I'm on about Tony bloody Blair. He answers to me and me alone. So, what do you want me to do then, Queenie? I need you to shut up. Bring me back a McDonald's. And do not forget ever again to record Coronation Street, even if you have to do it in short play, VHS form. Okay, Queenie, I will not forget. But what about if we run out of videotapes? Should I record over Diana and Charlie's wedding? Yes, we don't need that no more. Okay, Queenie. As I went down, the usual suspects, the Virginia Company. Never heard of myself either. Some theorists believe that the royal family heads the mysterious Virginia Company, an organisation that aims to run the world. Wow! The fall from grace of the royal family could have been a cleverly orchestrated public relations campaign to disguise their plans for world domination. Hell. Can I get in on that, please, Miss Queen? Which is nothing short of a re-establishment of the glory days of the British Empire. While they continue to project an image of reserved dignity and eccentricity, the royals secretly manage all major banking institutions and top-level security forces, such as the KGB, the Russian government, military, secret police bollocks. The royal family are behind it. It's not a surprise, is it? It's like this, I don't know enough about it, so I can't go into great detail, and I can't tell you my sources, but Jeffrey Epstein did not kill himself, or Epstein, he didn't kill himself. They were like, he apparently broke his, hung himself, yeah? There were 3 bones broken in his jaw or in his neck. Only 2 would have been broken if he'd hung himself. Mouse did only have been 2, but 3 were broken. He knew something about Prince Philip, the Queen's son. He knew what he'd been up to. He knew he was a bit of a naughty boy. So the Queen made a phone call. Yes, this is Black Hawk. Yes. Is that you, Queen? No, it's freaking Black Hawk. Just shut up. Do not use my code name. But that's your real name, Queen. No, it's Black Hawk. Just shut up. Now listen. Okay. What is it, Black Hawk? Badger needs to go in the hole and stay in the hole for good. Badger? Hey, what badger? Have you got badgers in your garden? No, not in the bloody garden in that prison in that place over the pond. There's a prison over the pond and the badger needs to go in the hall for good. Yes. Just so we're clear, Queen, what badger are we talking about? Is it the one with the dodgy hair who runs that country over the pond? No, not that muppet with the bad hair. No, badger, badger. Oh, badger, badger. I got you. So it's Jeff then. Yeah, Jeff. It's badger. Okay, consider it done. And it got done. So Prince Philip could be kept out of the loop and out of a prison. Because, you know, he would make a lot of friends in prison. There'd be a lot of people wanting to be his friend in there, trust me. There are even rumours that the royal family planned the American Revolution and that to this day they still rule sovereign of America's shores. Well, of course they do. Do you honestly think Trump really wants to manage a country without a hair? No, the Queen loves it. Hell yes, Donald, keep the hair. It's the best part about you. The British shadow government. The royal family may be nothing more than it seems, an ongoing media circus. The constant engagement of royalty opening paint factories, giving speeches or grabbing space in newspapers as they play polo may be designed to distract media and public attention from the activities of the British shadow government, an elite backroom conspiracy headed by ex-members of MI6. Sorry guys. As their forces quietly pass legislation in the House of Commons or test weaponry that will facilitate the coming of the New World Order, or NWO. The evening news pacifies the populace by showing Prince Harry getting his knee scraped on a games field. So basically, the royal family is behind this government, this New World Order, this organisation that plans to take over the whole world. He's got the whole world in his hands. No, he hasn't. The Queen has. The Queen's got the whole world in her hands. She's got you and me, brother, under her thumb. She's got you and me, brother, under her thumb. If she wants you and me gone, we are gone. Because the Queen has the whole world in her hands. Trust me, it's true. I said so. The unusual suspects. The imposters. The current House of Windsor could be a family of imposters. How dare you? Who lacked the apparently essential secret bloodline of Christ. They orchestrated the murder of Diana because as a Stuart, she alone possessed the true remnants of the bloodline. So basically, Diana was the real heir to the throne. And the Queen and Charlie and Buddy, William and Harry and all the other waffles, they were imposters. They did not have the bloodline that was needed to be in the house. Imagine now, can't you? Charlie, you have to marry Diana. But why, mother? I like Camilla. Charlie, you will marry Diana because she is the natural heir to this big house. Without her, I can't go on the coins or on the notes anymore. Because she could realise that she is the natural heir and have me kicked out of our big house and then we'll be living in Sheffield in the council flat. Charlie, get bloody married to Diana now. He's like, okay, mummy. But can I at least say goodbye to Camilla 10 more times, please? Please, mummy, please. My ears ain't quite clean yet. Charlie, if you see her more than one more time, I will disbar you from this house or whatever. I'll kick you out and I will send you to Nottingham to live on a council estate, okay? And you will not like Nottingham and all that council estate because it's a bad, bad area. Okay, mummy. Don't hurt me though. Just please don't write me out the will, mummy. I need the money, mummy. Okay, money. Money, mummy. Can I have some money, please? Charlie, go and find Diana now. Tell her she's welcome to sit and watch curry with me anytime she wants. Because it won't be for long, okay? After about 10 years, we can say goodbye to Diana for a while, okay? I said so. Most convincing evidence. Queen Elizabeth II is among the richest women in the world and is still head of the British Commonwealth. Yeah, she don't go around looking like the richest women, does she? Looks like she buys her clothes in a charity shop. A very expensive charity shop for royal people. A glaring anachronism in the days of blurring national boundaries and international culture. Instead of being relegated to a secondary position of nostalgic tradition, she still exerts a considerable amount of power, but uses it discreetly. Yes, they want to cancel Coronation Street. Tell them at the ITV people, studios, whatever. If they cancel Coronation Street, I will bring world abomination upon all of their houses. I will bring the plague down on you. You do not cancel my programme, okay? Get rid of EastEnders if you got rid of, get rid of anything. He's not on ITV though, love. I don't care. Get rid of the Bill then. I hate the Bill. It always takes up too much time and I want Coronation Street on even longer. Told you, she exerts a lot of power over everybody. The most mysterious fact to suggest that the present occupants of Buckingham Palace are a bunch of imposters is perhaps a bit strong. Of course it's not. It's damn true. However, there is a glaring question mark over their right to the occupancy and by extension their entitlement to all the power and wealth that goes with it. That question mark is provided by the questionable patronage of Queen Victoria, whose birth would, according to present medical and scientific knowledge, break the bloodline by which the present Windsors claim their rights. So, Queen Victoria was a dodgy one, basically. She was a bit naughty, let's get into it. Both haemophilia and porphyria are genetically inherited conditions. The latter suffered by Victoria's grandfather, Mayor George III. He was always mad. So, oh, I've got to get up now. Bloody hell. Oh, I've got to go to war now. For frick's sake. I just want to sit down and eat a big piece of chicken. Let me eat my chicken. What do you mean we've got no chicken left? I've got to go and capture some of them from another country. Always mad. Mad George III. Jake. it's alright, because now we have a legitimate heir to our throne. But it would be, guys. Now, let's be honest. In the last few years, the royal family have procreated faster than I can eat Christmas dinners. Every other year, there's another baby. What? Harry's got one, I think. William's got two. That's three more little sods that are gonna rule this country, even when my grandkids are around. How is that fair? Surely my grandkids should have a say in who runs the country. Surely they should have a choice if they want to rule the country. Why can't we pass it around a bit? Next week can be Bob's grandkids. 2 weeks after that can be Percy's grandson. Or the granddaughter of, Lindsay down the road. Why does he have to stick in the royal family? Tell me that. Why don't they convert, like I said, Buckpallies or where all them houses into homeless shelters, soup kitchens for the homeless? I bet they'd love it. You know, Barry from off the street just sleeping in the Queen's bed. The Queen living in a sleeping bag outside Boots in the town centre. It's only fair. Skeptically speaking, the fact that Coronation Street, I told you I played a part in all this, is still broadcast suggests royal intervention on a grand scale. Told you, the Queen loves curry and Chinese food and Mars bars, battered Mars bars from Scotland. She hated Diana because she was a real legit heir to the throne. She wanted rid of Diana. Paul Burrell nearly went to prison because he forgot to record Coronation Street. Charlie wanted to be with Camilla. The Queen only allowed it to happen if she stopped talking during Coronation Street. This is why it all panned out. You're allowed to be with Diana for a few years, get some kids out of her. Then we'll get rid of her. You can go off with Camilla. Diana can go off with her new husband. Dodi Al-Fayed, Mohammed Al-Fayed's son. Mohammed Al-Fayed, the former owner of Fulham, and I think he's still the owner of Harrods. The Queen was impressed. Why would my daughter-in-law get with somebody who's the owner of Harrods? What's wrong with the son of the owner of Primark? I love Primark, thought the Queen. If she's going to get it with the owner of Primark, then forget it. We'll make sure something happens. Now, Charlie, get back with Camilla. But I thought you didn't like Camilla, mother. I've changed my mind. She might just be alright, a bit dippy, and won't ask too many questions. If she does, we'll say goodbye to Camilla as well. That's me done, guys. I told you I'd bring you the truth. This is where you come every other Wednesday for the truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me God. You can't handle the